Hey guys, not long ago started messing with NinjaTrader strategy builder and NinjaScript. It is easy to make a buy and sell strategy what sells at the target and stops out at the stop level. But what if I want to add a trailing stop or add a break-even stop or take partials? Also be able to move your stop after strategy have entered the trade. There comes in ATM strategies. As we know, ATM strategies are easy to use buy or sell orders with attached profit target and stop loss. Also you can set up the break-even trigger and trailing stop can be executed on 3 price levels. The only downside to it is, not to be able to test your strategy on historic data. It must be tested on live data, or the playback connection. And you cannot use the basic strategy parameters like stopping out before market close. Also a little bonus at the end of video. Trade tracking spreadsheet for NinjaTrader. Can use it to store your playback, historic, own trading data in one place. Let's try to set up your first ATM strategy script. Be aware that you can't add the ATM strategies to Strategy Builder. At least just yet. At first let's create a simple buy condition in Strategy Builder. Let's open the Strategy Builder. Enter your strategy name. I will call mine testing ATM. Make sure there is no gaps or it won't accept it. We will calculate on bar close. We don't need any additional data. Click Next. Inputs and variables. Usually when building a strategy, you are entering here your input parameters and variables. Let's add here parameter of ATM strategies name. Click Add, enter name. Must be without gaps again. Type will be string as it's not number but letters. I will write ATM1, this will be the default now. Let's add another one of email length. Click Add again. Write a name. This time it will be integer. And write in your default value. Let's say 20. So, let's click Next, and add some conditions. Click to add a group. Name it. Change the drop-down choice to if all. If all conditions are met. Click Add. Let's add our exponential moving average. Let's make the moving average 2 bars ago less than same moving average 0 bars ago. Change the period to our user input we did earlier. Same on other side, find the EMA in indicator set it to 0 bars ago. Set the period to our user input. And we also can enable the drawing of the moving average. And don't forget to set that moving average 2 bars ago is less than moving average 0 bars ago. Also tick the box to plot it on the chart. And click OK. Let's add the next condition. What will be, let's say, if the candle 1 bar ago was a red bar. We click add, go to price, close. 1 bar ago, is less than price open 1 bar ago. This will be a condition for a red bar. Let's add another check where price close 0 bars ago is greater than price high 1 bar ago. so we got some bullish price movement. And let's also add a condition where we check if the trade is already open. We go to strategy, current market position equals market position flat, and click OK. Now let's add an entry order. Will be easier to understand where to put ATM logic afterwards. Click add at the bottom part of strategy builder window to do following. Let's create a market order to go long. Click order management and choose enter long position. Can leave the default settings as they are and click OK. So now we have created the basic strategy logic and we can start editing its script. We click the compile button. Wait for sound confirmation that everything is all right with the code and click the unlock code button. Be aware that after unlocking the code, it is not accessible from Strategy Builder anymore. Now only with NinjaScript. So, here is our simple strategy code. Now we can move over the ATM strategy template. Click on right side where you see strategies, and double click on sample ATM strategy to open it in a new tab. Now we can start extracting the parts we need. Let's grab these three lines of code located under the public class sample ATM strategy. Copy them under the private EMA EMA1. Now let's grab the line what checks if we are running the code on live data, not historical. Add it under the protected override void on bar update. This is where the strategy logic is located. Now let's copy the first condition what checks if the ATM strategy is in reset state. Paste it after the first open parenthesis in our strategy logic. Now let's grab all of the rest of ATM code. We need all of the code starting from line is ATM strategy created. Copy it as shown and paste it on top of these two lines. And last thing would be to change some of the basic ATM settings. Let's add the user input to the ATM strategy template, so you don't have to open the code every time you want to change the ATM strategy. Simply copy our ATM strategy user input variable and paste it in ATM strategy create logic. And now let's change some entry settings to enter our trade at the close of previous candle. You can choose the order type here. We will leave it to order type. Limit and change low to close. And also change the time in force from day to GTC. Now let's try to compile it and see if it works. Push the compile button at top of script. There always must be a sound what confirms the strategy code had no errors. Everything seems alright. Let's try it out. Go to your main NinjaTrader window and click on the connections menu. If you are connected to any of the other connections, click disconnect. Then we connect to the playback connection. It will show you a window where you can download your market replay data. This will act as live data and ATM strategy should work on it. Hopefully, select the instrument you want to do a test on, choose a date and click download. I can download as many days as you want. But be aware of the expiry. There is no point of downloading February data for expiry date of June. You would take the March expiry for February. When download is done, we click continue. You will need a chart to run your strategy. And it will be easier to understand how it is working. And also I would recommend to enable the chart trader so you can edit your ATM strategies easier. You can enable it at the top of your chart named as a chart trader. Now we also can add the ATM strategy. Go to the drop-down list under the ATM strategy and click Custom. Here you can set up all of the parameters for the ATM strategy. I gonna add that I am buying two contracts, Both stops gonna be 20 ticks or $5 and targets gonna be 40 and 60. Here you also can add your stop strategy, your trigger price for break-even, plus ticks above break-even, and your trailing stops. I will set my break-even trigger on 20 ticks, what is $5 plus 1 tick above break-even price. So it stops out 1 tick above break-even price. And also the trailing stop. As we had our first target at $10, let's set up the trailing trigger at 20 ticks or $5 and trailing stop on 8 ticks or $2. Click OK, and on next one we gonna add the same break-even trigger, and also a trailing stop. Let's say 2-step trailing stop. First profit trigger will be at $5 and we will trail 3. And the second one will start trailing $2 when price reaches profit of $10. Frequency is a setting for how often it will move the trail amount. We will leave it as it is. You can choose to save it as template, but this time we will leave the stop strategy as custom. We'll save the template for whole ATM strategy. Click Save as template. Let's name it ATM22 without spaces. You can use spaces, but this time I will not. Save it and click OK. Now we need to add strategy to the chart. Right click on the chart and choose strategies. Add our testing ATM strategy, change the name to ATM22 or whatever name you have. Enable it, click apply and OK. Now we are ready to try it out. Now just choose the dates and hit that play button. You can adjust the speed at the right side of it. For this strategy we won't need extreme speeds. So our strategy will trigger a trade on an uptrend. So we can speed it up, until we see one. Now we need a green candle to close higher than previous red candle to enter a position. We got an entry, let's see how it goes. This wasn't supposed to happen, seems like it is updating the ATM on every close. There is a quick fix for it. Go back to your script and search for line ATM strategy change stop target and change the stop 1 value to stop 6. This line of code is allowing us to move the stops when ATM is running. It is changing the stop because it is attached to first stop as stop 1. That's why I just change it to some higher number. And click compile. Now to reset the strategy we can disable it and then enable it again. This will reset it and use the new settings. Let's speed it up and see how it does. Not bad at all, but it doesn't mean it is profitable long term. Every strategy got periods of drawdowns. And this strategy is way too basic. Make sure to always test it with enough playback data before going live. If you want to see your trade results and export them to CSV file, you can do it at Trade Performance menu. Select your testing dates and filter by playback account, then it will show only the playback results. Here you can see the summary for the last playback run. When you run the playback again, your old playback results will disappear. For this purpose, I made an Excel workbook to store necessary playback information in one place where I can do a side-by-side comparison. Very useful when doing playback backtesting. There is loads of things you can do with the workbook. You can filter your trades by year, month, day, win or loss. By weekday, by hour, strategy. Also, you can add your mistakes. See each strategy side by side. Also, you can track your own trades, up to 22 accounts in one place. If you want to know more about the spreadsheet, check the links in description. Thank you for watching, and let me know if you got some questions.